Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming this morning. Thank you for joining. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. My name is Paul Eshipofuoriade. Thank you for coming this morning. Thank you. We started working. On this particular topic, this want to thank God for your life for coming. You've been talking about this particular topic. Feel free to go and share. Feel free to go and call your friends and family that we are here. And quickly, I just want to quickly give you something. I will give you the link as I promised yesterday. Well, you know the peculiarity of Nigeria, no light. Sometimes you burn the fuel finished, and all those things. And part of it, you get some things. So this morning, please go ahead and share the video. Invite your friends and participate as usual. My name is Paul Eshipofuoriade. This is a Special Drama Film School Online. Thank you for joining. We are still in the 5th month anniversary, 5th month anniversary ongoing from now till Saturday. So by the grace of God, I want to thank God for your life, and I just want to give a brief things that will help you, which I've written down, the meaning and the purpose of that thing. So we continue from the I will just join it together from the types of defamation which we started yesterday and all that. So we will go into the purpose of that law. Why do we have that media law? Majorly is to regulate the woman's conduct, because when people see what we act in our movies, they tend to behave that way. They tend to dress that way. They tend to have things that way. They tend to do exact what we are doing inside the movie. That's why you see somebody dressing like a particular model he has seen. It also reconciles the interest of individual to that community, for that society, pointing out the interest where it says, oh, this is interest, this is your right, and all that. Then he owes that kind of, when a man owes dignity to law, and then because the law in the change, a lot of changes in political arena, social arena, religious arena, also in economic arena, there are changes there. And you know, there are characteristics of this thing, because laws are normal to guide us what to do and what not to do, you know. And there are rules of law that are practicable in every country, that different countries have their rules of law. Different country has what they do and how it's being done. And I'm so happy, because in every law of the land, there are dynamism to every kind of law we have all over the world. All over the world, there are dynamism to what we have. Law is never static. That's why you discover what happened in Nigeria at the time that President Yar'Adua was on the throne. He died, and then the vice president was waiting. But when he died, after he died, there was an amendment of law that said anytime the president has to go out of the country for social time of the period, then the vice president become the acting president. So that's why you see the acting president of Chibajo. All right, that's why you see, because it's constitutionally in the law. It's constantly in the law. So please go ahead as you're joining. Mention your name, the country you are watching from, the state you're watching from, and please go ahead and share the video. It's very, very important. And we also have international law. These laws are they applicable between the two countries or more. We have a law that are applicable with a particular country that be further divided into headings. In that thing, in that international law, we have private law that apply to individuals, that apply to regulate the relationship between individual private people. And also, we have one that is a public law that is generally, that is why you have the ECOWAS. You have the ECOWAS country that are guiding principles, that are international law that guides them as they are going about. We have a substantive law, which also have the kind of a governing liability of a person in Nigeria. For example, we have a penal code, and also the part of it, penal code, is also applicable in the South. So it all depends on adjectival law. Adjectival law, we have a substantive law, we have a civil and criminal cases with laws that are guiding it. And let me be sincere with you. According to the post that I'm going to give you, according to the post, we discovered that Nigerian legislation and Nigerian case of law, the customary law and Islamic law, receive English law. And you know, it's so funny that Nigeria, there is no Christian law there. But you see in our constitution, you see Islamic law. All right? But you know, those are the things that God wants to shake, remove, and replace. You understand? Replace with something better, as we do this from time to time. But you know, one of the things is that many of us don't even know the essence of the law, and that is why we don't even know that law is a key. And different countries, different parts of the world, we have things that guides us, things that brings about a change, things that brings about a turning point. But unfortunately, even us as a media practitioners, many of us don't even know the laws and the ethics in Nigeria, which I'm going to be talking about probably tomorrow. The media law and ethics tomorrow, probably. Let me see. Yes, that's what I'll be talking about. Then to complement what I have given us today by the grace of God. But if I can go to it today, I may definitely go into it. But our media law that guides somebody called Vamasa Nigeria yesterday, Vamasa Nigeria yesterday, as we were talking, I was now, he said, oh, do you mean that there are laws that guides what we do in Nigeria as per media? I said, yes, there's no country of the world that doesn't have a media law. And there was a wow. So there is a media law, that is a fantastic law that Nigeria has. And that's the truth. We have a fantastic law. We have the law. Please confirm the picture. If you're having the picture very clean, let me know. If the picture is not clean, let me also know. If you're hearing my sound very well, let me know. Please feel free to go ahead and share this video with everybody and with everyone. And the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. My name remains Paul Isukpo for Oriade. And please, as you are watching, please just mention your name, the state or the country where you are and you are watching. In fact, you can tell us about your ministry. You can tell us about something, because very soon we're going to be doing that to a lot of people. And I want to appreciate all manner of works that people have been doing, which I'm going to appreciate more, because this work of God cannot be done by just only one person. So it's a collaborative work, and you have to just be where God wants you to be. So that's just a preamble for many of us. If you don't join yesterday, you know. And I discovered that every time, I can predict it, but most times I cannot predict, because I just felt, okay, the law. But later when I begin to sit down, do more research, sit down, pray, and discover, think also, because I don't only pray, I also think. The Bible says, whatever lovely, whatever things of good report, Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. That's my principle. Think on this. I think also. I call my room a prayer and thinking room. Why is it like that? Because the Bible says, whatever are noble, whatever things are honest, you think on this. You think. All right? So that's one of the things that we do. We stopped our types of defamation yesterday. And defamation is about defamatory statement made by plaintiff. The plaintiff as understood by members of the society. It means the way and manner it is made. And you know, one of the glorious things, one of the beautiful things that I keep on sharing is because these two types is in two. It's just two. The types of defamation. I don't want to give you, and I will be avoiding a lot of not too much, but I'll be avoiding a lot of law jargons or technical jargons from the law. You know, it's not bad. It's just that some of us may be pissed off, but it's better you know it, because I love it, and not because I love it, I just want to know. And that's why I love quoting, and that's why you cannot quote it off and most times unless you already imbibe yourself into it. There are two types of defamation which I've mentioned so much, and I'll keep on mentioning, because I want us to get it and get it right. Once we get it and get it right, it goes a long way. What is that? And that is the defamation type. The defamation, we have a libel, law of libel, and we also have slander, law slander. So it should be pointed out that rather to lose something, I told you that even the vulgar abuse, if it's not really constituted, it may not be something you can actually keep somebody for. But like I said, when it comes to the definition of libel and slander, you discover that in law of libel, it can be defined as everything, anything printed, written, which reflects on the character of another person, or is published without lawful justification. Without lawful justification or excuse is a labor, is a libel rather, because whatever the intention may have been, once it's written down, you know, it's a permanent thing. You cannot erase it. If I've written a book now, anything I'm saying now, even if I say I don't want to say it, I'm saying it, but somebody, a computer, somebody is transcribing it. Once it's transcribed, it becomes a legal thing. And once it's on the other hand, you know, if like on slander, slander is something you say in a, maybe a video, an interview, something you say concerning a person, a false statement, word of mouth, or in other transient form. Or format that you know. And let me regularly tell you the distinction between the two. You know, I'm going to give you the reference of really. So the distinction between two, because I can say anything. I say, what's wrong with that guy? What is wrong? Is he the only drama minister in the land? And what is the problem, sir? He's too pompous. He's too this. That's slander. And the Bible kick against the slanderer, being slanderous. You know, the Bible talks about that. You know, and you know, love libel. The libel is so terrible because libel is written down. The libel is so terrible because it's permanent. Nobody, you cannot erase it. You cannot do anything to it. It's forever. So the slander is defamatory, conveyed in transcendent manner, made by words and gesture only. That's slander. But when it comes to libel, I've written it down. Nobody can say it's not like that. And that is why I fear things, posting things on Facebook or social media or on Twitter or on Snapchat or on Instagram. When you post anything, whether picture or anything, if it's something blasphemous, you know what it is. And sometimes some of us don't even know how to present our English. We don't know how to, that's why sometimes when I'm beginning to think something, I call my friends, especially my wife. I call my wife and I ask my wife, please, I need your help, please. And she will tell me, this is what is sustainable. This is not going to be the meaning that people will have for it. So slander is a business for ear to conceive and comprehend. That slander is for ear. When you say it, it causes a problem. And it's not actionable per se. Except in some few cases, it's not actionable per se. But whereas, if it's the libel matter, it's a defamatory matter, conveyed a permanent form, like I tell you, it's forever in a way, if I'm going to say, use that word forever in quotes, it's made in writing, conveying through signs. You can do the sign, I can draw a sign here. Whatever is there now, I cannot remove it. Oh, I can also make it a kind of a theme. I can do a theme. I can do a movie and to do a kind of a statement, making something in that theme. I can create, because that theme cannot be erased. Once I've said that Abeokuta is in Nigeria, is in Ibadan. You know, it's Abeokuta is not in Ibadan. Abeokuta is in Ogun State. So I cannot say something that is not correct. And once it's inserted in the film, it becomes a permanent thing. Do we get it now? It becomes a permanent thing. So another thing is that effigy. You can put the effigy. You can put it on the pictures. You can put it on cartoons. You can put it on photographs of our posts. If you like, delete it from your own end. It doesn't been deleted from my own end, because immediately you post it, I might have downloaded it or have automatic downloaded downloading principle on my libel. Actionable per se. Let's go to the next one. Now, you know, so, like I told you yesterday, you can defend the charges of different who can also defend himself. And you know, this is one of the things the defense can enumerate ways. In four different ways, you can have a kind of absolute privilege, fair comment, justification, and finally qualification privilege. Apart from these four, there are more, you know, how you can do your research depending on some things. People defense, like I said, defense of innocence. Generally, I wait for newspaper, people that read about it. I'm just a vendor. I'm just a seller. I can't read every book in my store. So how do I get this thing done? I don't know about it. So are you selling something that is promoting something, whether you get it? So why am I promoting it? So as you're joining, please go ahead and share the video. Go ahead and share the video. And in the course of the lecture, I appreciate many of us as we're joining. Thank you for joining this morning. I really appreciate it. So as I was talking, they can be raised. It can be raised and say, "Stop it! I'm ignorant. I'm innocent of it. So I am innocent of it, and it could be very, very funny because I'm just doing my own business. I don't know that it's something. And they are ignorant of the libelous matter or issues on the book or anything that claim that they are selling. The proof is therefore on the defense to lay evidence to prove this ignorance and then label. And so, sorry, because I was neglected. I have a negligence about it. I'm sorry about it. And the difference of absolute privilege. Let me quickly explain it a bit. When you talk about difference of absolute privilege, it inhibits a free discussion without fear and favor of matter of the public, because it employed the defamation matter alleged to preceding courts of proceedings of the court of law or legislative house, where therefore the defendant was alleged to have defamed the plaintiff in the event legislative house or legislative house. The case of against the same view was the head in case against Punch Limited. The court heard that a fair and absolute report, an absolute report in newspaper or proceeding heard before any court exercising judicial authority. Sorry, the network is breaking, but it's okay. I can manage it by the grace of God. I'm going to the grace of God. So it's part of the thing. So if you can see me clearly, just give me a thumb up. Then I know that okay, you can hear well with it. All right. So what am I saying? That the judicial authority published contemporaneously with the proceeding is absolute privilege. So number two is the fair comment on the strength of the fact that right of expression abhors the principle in quote that debates uninhibited, robust or wide open. And then let me tell you something, you need to understand all this procedure. You need to, because if you don't understand, it becomes a problem. It becomes something you have to look at from time to time, that the comment on the fact is true. If the comment is true, definitely, thank you. If the comment is true, definitely the whole world will leave you. The courts of law will leave you alone. Well, there is to be a fair comment. And there may be somebody said, our president is sick. Our president is sick. That student is not healthy. And somebody said, oh, that's too harsh too. Oh, our president is not feeling fine. He said, that's not too good. Oh, I want something punchy. I want something catchy. All right. So you need, it's funny. It has to be very, very direct and not offensive. Not offensive, because those are the things, those are the primary purpose of what you need to understand. And another thing is that the motive of dishonorable nature must not be there. The insincere expression on the part of the defendant, you have to also look at it, and you have to be very careful about it. The next point, number three, is defense of truth and justification. And when you're speaking the truth and justification, you have to be very careful, because there are two perverted on fact and truth, and for the same person, for the same reason, overlap one another. The defense of justification is the opinion that no allegation of defamatory matters shall subsist where the defendant maintain that it is true and justifiable in that regard. Now, this was the very few express things that you need to understand. And then, let me just put it that way. And then number four, with the last one, is the defense of qualified privilege. If the truth is to be told on the general interest and the matter of the society, you need to do the right thing. You need to do the right thing. Only few people have shared this video. Please go ahead and share this video. I need help now, so I've shared the video. Please go ahead and share the video. Go ahead and share the video. So, excuse me. I need help. Please, as I was talking about it, All right. So I discovered that you need to pay attention to do in in doing what you need to do, in paying the attention of those things and all that. So you need everything to check and cross-check. You need to very, very careful. You need to be very, very careful on how you put your truth. If something, if it's correct, it's correct. If it's not correct, it's not correct. So let me quickly answer some questions here. Then I'll post it because, like I told you yesterday, it wasn't my write-up. I only have a few things added to it. So I just have things being brought into it. So who can be? Anybody can be defamed. Anybody can be defamed. Anybody has a legally. Anybody can be arrested, and then the action of libel originate from the medium in print. Once it's printed, you are free. You can sue the person. You can talk about it. Remember, when it's put on the television, it becomes a serious issue. You know, and you know the Defamation Act we refer to here is a federal law which has been operative in Lagos when federal government moved to Abuja in December 1992. The 1961 Defamation Act became there. It became there in Abuja, the law in operation in Lagos. As it's operating in Lagos, also operates other part of Nigeria. Thus, the Defamation Act is by and large the same act by different name in various states. So in various states, they call it different names, but it's the same thing. Just that the place of libel vis-a-vis political broadcast. When somebody is using a word, somebody wants to campaign, he has something he has to say, he has something he must not say, and all that. So just as a newspaper is liable for what is published, say the same thing, a drama minister is liable to what is teaching and all that. That's why sometimes when we many of us are not subjected to heresy, when they say somebody is not preaching right or is saying something fallacy, somebody say, a pastor said, let me sit down on you, let me step on you, so that the man step on you, you go to the new level. I don't know where that one is done. So the next point I want to share this morning with us is law of sedition. And I think I'll be stopping at law of sedition this morning. Then I'll be stopping once I finish law of sedition. I will be stopping on that. Like I told you, I'm going to tell you some things tomorrow about the media law and ethics that will help you and all that. All these articles, articles I read, and I wanted to form a note out of it, but I felt, let me share my experience with those things. Let me share my experience with the great things that I need to pay attention to. So, law of sedition. The after-cited definition for sedition is one crotch by Fitzgerald in J. And it describes sedition in the following words. It describes sedition in the following words. Gracie, it typed on the following one. So, sedition is a crime. Sedition is a crime against society, nearly allied to that of treason, and it frequently precedes treason by a short interval. It is a comprehensive term, and it embraces all those practices, whether by word, clause, or writing, circulated by disturb the tranquility. You know, sometimes that's why many of us don't like all this law. But let me be sincere with you and make it simpler for you. Under the Nigerian criminal law, sedition is defined under section 50, subsection 1 of the criminal code, applicable to Southern 14 juries, and define a sedition publication as a publication having a sedition intention. And sedition section 50 and subsection 2, defines sedition intention as intention. Number one, to bring in hatred and contempt, or to excite disaffection against the person of the head of the federal government, the governor of a state, or the government or constitution of Nigeria, or a state as by law established, or against the administration of justice in Nigeria. Or number two, to excite Nigeria to attempt to power the alteration otherwise than by lawful means, or any other matter in Nigeria as by law established. Or C, to raise discontentment or dissatisfaction and disaffection among inhabitants of Nigeria. Or 4, D, to promote feeling or ill will and hostility between the different classes of the population of Nigeria. All these things are in the law. All these things are in our constitution. You need to get all this in the constitution. If you have access to the constitution of Nigeria, I guarantee you, you have all these things and you can read it out from the law. A computable provision can be found under the section 416 of the Northern Nigerian Penal Code law. This section provides whoever by words, either spoken or reproduced by metical means or intended to be read or by sign or by visible representation, that is fame, or otherwise excite or attempt to excite facing of disaffection against the person of Her Majesty, her heirs or successor of the person of the Governor General or Constitution of the United Kingdom or Nigeria or any Nigerian there or of against the Ministration of Justice in Nigeria, I love this, or any region shall therefore be punished with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 7 years or fine or between those. Those are the when the colonial era part of the constitution given to us. That's why you say you see the United Kingdom there or Nigeria, because that's when they are ruling us, when they are colonizing us. So from the above stated provision, sedition can be generally be defined really by any statement or representation which has the intention to stir up treason, defame the person of the head of state or governor of the state, or incite the one section of population against one another, or just want to cause problem in the society, or just want to cause trouble for us. We need to understand this. And the object of law of sedition are to induce or insurrection, stir up opposition of the government. Just like when the Biafra people came up, they came up, and the Boko Haram people came up, a lot of things to cause the trouble. In a nutshell, it has affected the invigorating public disturbance. These two things have affected, then ignite civil war. It can ignite civil war. And the important aspect of the law of sedition is that the student must understand the aspect of sedition. All of you as a student, you must understand the seditious conspiracy. Seditious conspiracy, seditious libel, seditious speech. Who may be convicted for this law? Oh, you know, you have to understand it. Is the law of sedition still relevant? The constitutional basis of the law of sedition is still there. So the seditious conspiracy is the agreement or plan by two or more persons to overthrow or destroy by the force. You know, to put down by unlawful means or to destroy by the force of the government of the country. Yesterday, there was supposed to be a rally. There are some parts of the country, beautiful Nubia, Two-Face was to lead some things, and he was not there to lead those things. And, you know, and some people went, some places in Abuja, in Lagos, where some people were stopped by the police and all that. So, you know, a lot of things can happen after that. Some people can go to court with that. Some people can be arrested about that. And then, you know, those are sort of things you need to know as a drama minister, so that you don't do things, you don't just put your placard, you don't just put your film, you don't just do anything inside your film. And when you're writing film, all these things, you see the reality of it. If you know the law, you'll be able to know how to present it in your storytelling. That's why I'm going to hit. You'll be able to know how to present this thing in your storytelling. You don't just write things from the blues. It doesn't have any relevance to the government. It doesn't have any relevance to the society. It doesn't have any relevance to the body of Christ. And you'll be wondering, why is this thing? Please, if you have not shared this video, go ahead and share this video. And please mention your name so that I can appreciate you at the end of the class. So the next one is seditious libel. Seditious libel. You know, it's one thing you need to understand. It's another thing. I'm appreciating some people this morning. All right, the seditious libel. This is any communication in written or any other permanent form which has intention to incite people to change the government by unlawful means, that they want to overthrow the government by unlawful means. You can use this. You can use film to do this. I'm telling you. You can use film to do a lot of things. If you have watched The Unit, you understand what I'm talking about. It's an American film. If you have watched The Unit, you know, you understand what I'm talking about. If you have watched some things. In fact, we have a Latse. There is a Christian film called Latse. That Latse is a prophecy. It's a prophecy about God for that reason, people disturbing the nation, people disturbing us, people affecting us, people doing all manner of funny things. And that film, the prophecy in that film is that the Godfather died suddenly. And it happened exactly like that in Ibadan, in the city of Ibadan, when a very popular Godfather in Ibadan died. like that, according to that faith, as it was written for us. We are more prophetic about it, so we can use the prophetic means to destroy the enemies of the nation, the enemies of our soul. So the citizen level, it can be like that, which advocate for overthrown of the government. And you know, that will cause a lot of problem for such people, because once you do that for the government is going to do, are going to react back. So you need to understand this as a media law. So before somebody bring out that paper, newspaper, that magazine, that thing, that book, there are laws that are guiding this thing as a drama minister. As a Christian filmmaker, you must know the law of the land. You must understand the law of the land. You cannot bring the government by force or which advocate the destruction of the state. Some people, just like what happened recently when they began talking about constituted authority, when the government, the student of a particular school, I don't want to mention, of a particular state, and they begin to talk with their governor very rudely and all that. The government was saying something else, though I'm not justifying one of them. So both of them are, to me, in my own perspective, in my own opinion, both of them are wrong, because no matter when some two wrongs are not making right, that's my submission. So the next one is dirtiest speech. Now this is any speech which advocate the overthrown of the government or destruction by force. Please, if you have not shared this video, go ahead and share this video, and please make a comment. In case you have any question, feel free to ask your question, and by the grace of God, I will put an answer to that. So the next one, who may be convicted for this sedition, section 51 of the criminal code makes the following person liable for sedition. Make it for sedition, and make it for sedition. All right, it makes it for sedition. Number one, anyone who does a seditious act or takes part of the preparation or conspire with other to commit sedition or utter seditious word, also liable are printers, publishers, distributors, vendors, reproducers, importers of seditious publication, all of them. So even the printer, they will trace them. Even the producer, they will trace them. Even the publisher, they will trace them. Do you see that? That's a media law for you. So the law of sedition, number the next one, is still relevant. This person, is it relevant? That's the question. It has not been noted that the law, it has been noted that the law was one of the first press law enacted by British colonial administration in the protectorate of southern Nigeria at that time to check rising press of criticism. They don't want people to criticize them. They don't want anybody to talk ill about the government. And many journalists at that time and nationalists of that era were, as a result, jailed. Many of them were jailed. The newspaper heavily fined. Many of them were fined. In fact, till now, even last 2 years, I saw some radio in Ibadan. There is a particular radio station in Ibadan. Let me mention Ebilo used to interview a lot of people. He will interview, in fact, that guy is something else. If we call you on the program, if you're not yet prepared, you're going to have a lot of problem with him, because it's going to get you and get at you. And that's the work of a journalist. Anyway, on the attainment of independence, therefore, the nationalists had expected that such obnoxious law would be expunged from the status, but many people even left it. Indeed, some progressive judges at that time tried to put it in place, that such law has no place in an independent Nigeria. But 50 years after, the law still occupies a prominent place in the status. Can you see where we have a problem? A lot of things are supposed to be removed from our law till now. That is why when people say they have Islamic law in the constitution, is because the northern protectorate at that time they were able to accommodate the Islamic law into the law, so that they can have a peace with them. They can have a kind of a favoritism with them. That's why it got there. But after 50 years, even after how many years now? After 50 years, it's still there. We are 50 what now? 56, 57 this year. Nigeria will be 57 this year by October 1st. You remember we are growing old and all that. So those against the retention of the law of sedition pointed out it denies people their fundamental human right of freedom, of free expression, freedom of expression. It violates the right to criticize government and deny the people their right. of self-determination. So those are the things, and you need to know all these things, because they argue further that the law of sedition could be misused by dictator overreach himself, but therefore let them remove it. But they have not removed it. I think by the grace of God, some of you watching, if you're a lawyer, if you're a barrister, you're a lawyer, please, I pray that you pay attention to this area, and this can be removed from our government law. All this Islamic law, let it be a normal law that has no religion, that is not religion biased. But we are kingdom people. We're going to bring a kingdom principle to the nation of the world, even to this country, by the grace of God. So, but those who support the retention of the law present a counter argument. They also argue that the law of sedition is aimed at protecting the government and institution which are established by law to serve Nigerian people. And without such a law, act of treason such as incident of right to riot, destruction of public properties, and the enthronement of anarchy could be perpetrated by lawless people to the detriment of the state. So while arguing that the right to free expression is not absolute, they insist that such right impose a corresponding duty on the citizen to respect constituted authority and stay with the provision of the law. And that is why they say, I'm a constituted authority. Well, in drama ministry, we have constituted authority too. In drama film ministry, we have constituted authority, because anything you can do. And you know, one of the things that we have zero tolerance for is this pseudo-Christian films, kind of heretic Christian films. There are principles. That's why we have Ansidra. I'm still going to talk about Ansidra, like I promised us. I'm going to talk about Ansidra. And it's one of the associations I'm going to be talking about, by the grace of God, which I'm a member of Ansidra. I'm proud to be a member of Ansidra. And I'm going to tell you Ansidra, what it means, what Ansidra means, and all that, what Ansidra means. So the issues of whether the law of the sedition is still relevant or not in Nigeria was said to be in case of Wanko and the state, Innocent Adiku, and the House of Representatives. In this case, the right expression and press was expanded to include relevant and caustic remark against government and public officers which conduct the public field to comment or condemn. You know, I will make all this, by the grace of God, make all this note available unto Ross. By the grace of God, I'll make all this available unto us by the grace of God today, and I also posted for yesterday thing. So by the grace of God, those are the things you need to understand. The law of the land as a media practitioner, as a media consultant, by the grace of God, I go into all these things so that I can know what is obtainable. People are out there to cheat you because they know that whatever you put in the paper, somebody has rightly said, if you want to cheat an African man, if you want to do anything for an African man, put it in a book for an African man. An African man may never read it. And that is why they are also afraid. They are also fearful. They are afraid of people. I've said it, please. Don't call me when I'm doing something. Please, I beg you, please. It's only weekend you can do that. It's only weekend you can do that. On Saturday you can do that. All right. So, you know, you must know the law of the land. You must understand the principle that guides the law of the land. You must embrace the law of the land very well. You must embrace the law of the land adequately, because defense available to journalists in charge of sedition. You remember there was a particular time some journalists were seized for several times in Egypt, when Egypt was following the law, and they are facing the war. So we need to the principle. We need to understand law. By tomorrow, I'm going to talk about ethics. I'm going to talk about federal, what guides the law that guides a radio station, the law that guides a television station. I'm going to talk about that, and that will be part four of this. Filmmakers, you need to know this thing as a filmmaker. You may be looking at it, what is it to me? It has a lot of things to do, because your script can go out. You can publish your script. You can do a lot of things towards your script. And once you do that to your script, you know what it means. It goes a long way. It goes a long way. It's a brilliant way. By the grace of God, it goes a long way to do something. Let me quickly appreciate some people before I go on. If you are there, please drop your note or drop I so that we know you are there. I want to appreciate Kolo Peter this morning. Thank you very much. You are the first person. All right. I want to appreciate Pastor Inkiru Ojimadu. She said, I prefer to be called Inkiru. Inkiru. Inkiruka. Inkiruka. But I don't know how to pronounce it very well now. I used to know how to pronounce it. So it's Inkiru Ojimadu, Pastor. Pastor Deborah Cole. God bless you, evangelist. Oh, he's also a pastor. Akintewe Akinyele Luz. Thank you very much. Wow, wow, wow. Can you imagine somebody I have in the class today? And that is Sister Stella Feintola New. Wow, 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 wow. These are wonderful people. I must confess, begin to learn deep things. Having followed the teachings and the principles that is going on that are deeper than the conventional teachings of Pastor Sunday. And I saw a lot of things about Pastor Sunday Adelaja, and I said, wow, this is awesome. This is beyond. This is one of the things I have before. This is one of the principles I have before. And I saw somebody going in that direction, very deeper than I have. Very deeper than I. Taking the Word of God into a deeper dimension. And I want to appreciate that. And I want to thank God for your life. And there's so many people that are showing likes that I don't see you unless you tell me, unless you see yourself, unless you mention. Just say I. Like I said, just say I. Let me know where you are. Ogundipe Olabi Peters, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Please, if you are still there, please mention your name. Then I will appreciate that you are here. I will appreciate that you are here. I will appreciate that you are here. So, like I said, about that law, you need to understand the principle that guides the filmmaking, the principle that guides us. Because even when you have your territorial limitation, there are territorial limitations in the law. There are some things that are not obtained in another country. You cannot put in Nigeria. I don't have to pay bill for everything. I take responsibility. I can tell the Nepal that, please, I don't need your light. I want to be on solar. I can build a house and I put solar all through that generate light for me. All I need, I have to get license to get those things into the country. Once I get the license, I pay. Unfortunately, some people have started doing something that MTN will give you a solar thing and you begin to pay monthly. I discovered that almost everything, well, it's well. There are lots, there are codes and all the things. And you know, there are something that apply in the South. Why the code and criminal codes apply also in the North? In Nigeria, but all these things happen because of the colonial era that we have, and the breach of law is enforced by sanction and coercion. When you have a breach of law, is you are enforced by sanction or coercion. This can be done through organized institution such as the police force, the law court, the prison officers, etc. It is this element of sanction in law that distinguishes law from other concepts such as ethical rules, convention, morality, and etc. Because tomorrow I'm going to be talking about the media law and ethics by the grace of God. I'm going to be talking about that. So law is very dynamic. It's not something you can just put in a straitjacket. And the way we interpret it will differ. And because those are the things, that's the work the lawyers have done so far for us in the land. If somebody should pirate my film, what is the next step I should do? Many times I keep quiet, like I said, but if I were you, you need to understand. Look at this thing. Look at this to mention to the sources of this Nigerian law. The sources of this Nigerian law. How the Nigerian law get to this place? Because this provides a law that must be applied to matters. The sources of Nigerian law, I have given you before, I want to give you again. Five sources of Nigerian law. Number one is received from English law. That is, from colonial eras. From the colonial government. The number two, he derived from Nigerian legislation. How they can do this, how this can be done in Nigeria. Another thing, it came from the Nigerian case law. Nigerian case law, how things happen within the citizenry, how it's been handled. The next one is customary law. Customary law. Okay, this person is the local government thing. Okay, this is within my house. How do I do? The last law is Islamic law. That's why you have a Sharia in our law. And that's the sources of our law. And you know, when you are doing those kind of a thing, for academic purposes, that is why I'm giving you all this detail. For academic purposes, that's why I'm giving you all these things. I want to appreciate Mr. Feintola for joining, because this is awesome. And we are believing God to have more students as from today by the grace of God. And I also want to appreciate a woman of God, also quite a number of them, a woman of God, Anastasia Madonna. Thank you, yesterday for a wonderful encouragement and for a wonderful word, and we were able to chat. I want to appreciate my father in the Lord, Evangelist Mike Bamiloi, a kind of wonderful mentor and a father indeed, because he has really, really been an encourager. I'm sorry to say this, for you, some of the drama ministers who have met me, and the best you can tell me is discouraging word. Thank you for doing that. It is well with you. We are not discouraged, and we're not going to be discouraged. This is not going to stop, except the Lord will say we should stop it. I've seen a lot of people tactically, ignorantly, innocently, they begin to say all manner of things to discourage. Well, Paul Ishikpofuriade and his team have refused to be discouraged, because God sent us here and also sent us on campus. God sent us. So I want to appreciate Evangelist Matthew Olugbenga Bamidele of the Manzion Faith Ministries. I want to appreciate Evangelist Abraham Adebayo. I also want to appreciate the Adebayos. I want to appreciate all the two Adebayos. I want to appreciate Akintudes, the Akintudes and Manzion. These are people who keep on encouraging me, even when I don't even fully understand what God is giving me to do. They keep on encouraging me. They call me on, not only physically, they also pray. That's one thing. I'm sorry I'm making it public, because I'm excited with these things. But like I said, I'm sorry for any drama minister who meets me and the best they can give me is to discourage and say, you people, I was telling somebody how much I spent on the internet. Say, that's somebody's salary. I laugh, because he's only know about salary to meet somebody. But this one is serving a lot of people. People are here from different parts of the world, from Ukraine, from Germany, from Spain, from England, mention yourself, from Ireland, from Manchester, from different places of the world from that I have not been to. So I want to appreciate John Oluwadunsin. That is it. That's the word for me. Oluwadunsin, Oluwani Moroti. I love your name, all your names. Oluwani Moroti, John Oluwadunsin. What does that mean? It's a Yoruba name. Oluwani Moroti means the Lord is my anchor. I stay with the Lord. And Oluwadunsin means it's sweet to serve the Lord. It pays to serve Jesus. That's the language. I love that song. It pays to serve Jesus. I sing from my heart. You know, I'm going to die on my duty post, because part of the duty post is the internet class that we are doing on daily basis. And you know, Monday through Friday, 9:30 a.m. Nigerian time, Monday through Friday, 9:30 Nigerian time. And also on weekend, Saturdays, we have question and answer. And last week, we said we're going to repeat it. But the question is it wrong for me to act in a secular movie? If it is wrong, then give me opinion. And is it wrong for me to bring a secular artist to my movie? If it's wrong, you share my opinion. And when I said this, some people thought, is Brother Paul acting in a secular movie? No. I'm not acting in a secular movie. No, it's a question somebody asked. And I want us to come and share our opinion Saturday by 9:30 p.m. But you start calling in, if you want to call, by 9:35. You start calling by 9:35 so that you give me the 5 minutes of introduction and all that. So by 9:35, you start calling in. These are the principles. These are the guiding principles. These are the good things that God has been able to give to us to do as a child. You know, it takes the grace of God. If you ask me some years ago, I have a passion of online school. I have a passion to do online school. I have a passion to create an online school, the Christian drama film school online. I have the passion. That's why you see me joining all manner of online classes, all manner of things, to learn, to see how things are being done and all that. And this is 5 months. 5 months. People talk and say, Brother Paul, your name is so you're so done. You're consistent. And I say, all glory to God. He's the one that gives the grace. Quite a number of people are in full time. They have not discovered who they are, what they can do. I just have a brief word for you this morning. Think within. There is something on inside of you that can bless the world. And I've said it before. This is not meant only for Paul to be doing. You can also go out of the Facebook Live or go out to another platform. You can do something for the Lord. Let that be multiplication of Christian drama everywhere. Let us be teaching the word how Christian drama is being done, and to give a legacy to generations to come. It's not limited to Paul Ishikpofu. You can also try the drama school film online. You can also dive a Christian film school online. It's our word. Let's do something. Let's drop something for the Lord. So concerning the law, we'll continue tomorrow. I don't want to go to eat, because if I go to eat now, I may not be able to finish I may not be able to finish. So, but tomorrow, by the grace of God, I will be talking about it. I'll be talking about the constitutional base of the press, what the press man needs to know, the decree. Those are the things I'm going to be talking about tomorrow. The independence, the 90s, all the things that the media law has been defined that to regulate the activities of the nation. So those are the things. If you have any question, let me answer your question before I go this morning. Let me answer your question. And if you are watching this video offline, when I'm not online, feel free to drop your question and answer. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel. We have so many films. We have so many short films you can use for your preaching. Maybe you are preaching, you have something that has to do with example. We have a film on example, which is Apere. Or you are a proprietor of school. Your teachers or Christian teachers used to come late to the school. We have a film for you titled Correct It. So somebody who came late to school and was giving excuses, and it was to sign 7:30, and he was signing. He came around 8 and was signing 7:45. Which is a lie as a child of God. We have films like that. We have people who want to marry and your parent is insisting of going to the rituals or those things they need to bring. We have a film for you called Link with Deity. So we have a lot of films. We also have a film that somebody got the film Lost. You know, we also have a short film that you can watch. We have over 20 short films you can watch and enjoy. We have so many of them. Let me see if I can get some other topics also here. So we have so many of them like that you need to. Let me appreciate. Okay, Olu Addison, thank you, sir. Pastor Cole says, thank you, Bro Paul. More blessings. Amen. Amen. Thank you, man. Thank you so much. Any other person, any questions so far? And our film is still out, The Broken Dream. The Broken Dream. Any part of the world you are, just contact us. We'll be able to tell you how to get the film to you. If you have to give a password so that you can download it, we will give you a password so that you can download it as soon as we... I was to upload it in January, but the co-producer said I should hold on for now, and that's why you didn't see it online. And some of the films, you also even use a smartphone. We're still going to do that by the grace of God online. I have to use a smartphone to shoot a movie and also to edit a movie. So all those things will be done and all that. So there are quite a number of titles. We have Corrective series. We have Mr. Perfect. That's one of the latest we have shot already. We have shot about 8. We have shot The Scroll. Daddy Matthew, please. I need the Yoruba version. What the Yoruba meaning of Scroll? The Scroll. I need the Yoruba meaning of The Scroll because I need that. We inbox you. I need that one. Mr. Perfect, we have done Stop It. We have done Stop It. We have done quite a number of films by the grace of God. We also help somebody or some people to do a film called Demon Harvest. Demon Harvest. You need to watch that one. You need to watch Demon Harvest. It will help you. Go and subscribe to our YouTube. You have tens of films for now. We're still going to upload as many as possible in the course of the year. So please go ahead and share this video. Go ahead and tell the word about what God is doing and all that. I've not really come out to tell you about what the Lord is using us to do in SEDME, but it's not yet time. That is why I didn't talk about it. Any question before I go? I want to appreciate every one of us who have joined this morning. Any question? Question. Question. Do you have any question? Okay. Any question, Brother John? Any question? I pray for good success in your exam. Brother Owolabi Peter Ogundipe. Wow, my family is watching. Rotimi Oriade. Thank you, my big uncle. Thank you very much. Sister Stella Feintola Nu. Thank you for joining. Akintewe Leos, Pastor. Thank you for joining. Please go ahead and share this video. If you have not shared this video, please go ahead and share this video. It's very important to share this video. Thank you for sharing this video. Please go ahead and share this video. I want to appreciate all of you for sharing this video. And I want to give kudos to my father and the Lord, Evangelist Mike Bamiloye and Gloria Bamiloye. I use this video to say happy birthday to Mama Bamiloye. Thank you. The Lord keep you. The Lord preserve you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you, Mama. Thank you for the encouragement. You're such an encouraging mommy. That's my mommy. Thank you so much. I appreciate all the fathers and mothers in Drama World. I want to appreciate all of you. Thank you for your encouragement. And that's what I have this morning. I want to be logging out in the next 1-2 minutes. So if there's no question, I will be logging out like that. I will be logging out like that. Sorry for all the breaks in transmission of the network. But thank God. Nothing can stop us. We are determined. We are able to possess the land. In the name of Jesus, we are overcomer. We are able to possess the land. We shall make it. In the name of the Lord, we shall make it. By the power of His word, for the greater one is on the inside of us. We are Joshua generation. Nothing can stop us. We are determined. We are able to possess the land. In the name of Jesus, we are overcomer. We are able to possess the land. Thank you very much, Sister Nessia Madonna. Mention your name earlier. Good morning, Paul. Thank you. Thank you, Mark. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. I want to appreciate all of you, all the likes, all the love. I want to appreciate you. You need to watch this video again, share the link, and invite more people. Till tomorrow, 9:30 a.m. Nigerian time. Thank you very much. I appreciate you. And my co-host, a wonderful voice. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Please go and share this video. I invite people, and we appreciate you. God helping us. Any question, finally, before I go? Any question, finally? Thank you very much for joining. You as a media person, you as a media practitioner, you must understand, even an advertising agency, you must understand there is a law that guides your land, and there are some laws that are sentimental, that if you know about it, even if you're as a lawyer, you can actually work on it. You can actually do something on it. You can actually fight it. What I mean by fighting it, you can actually fight it lawfully. Those are the principles. Oh, Pastor Evangelist Matthew said, God bless you. Thank you, sir. I really appreciate your support. I want to thank you for your life. Oh, please, the Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. Till tomorrow, my name remains Paul Esupo for Oriade. I remain your lead instructor on the Special Drama Film School Online. Thank you. Till tomorrow. Bye.